Hello friends and welcome back to my channel Teacher Sneha. In this video we are going to learn about 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation about origin. In the previous video we have learnt about 90 degree clockwise rotation about origin. You can find the link of that video also in the description box. And now let's focus on 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation about origin. So what is an anti-clockwise rotation? So when you are moving in an opposite direction of the clock, we call that as an anti-clockwise movement. Now how do we calculate and how do we plot that on the graph is what we are going to focus in this video. So if the original coordinates are x and y, after 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation, they become negative y and x. As I have told you in the first video about a simple trick to memorize the formula, here again that trick is implemented. When we are rotating anti-clockwise, we are taking a turn towards our left, and that's why over here you can see after x and y they flip their positions, the left side coordinate changes its sign. So again, it's very easy, you don't have to memorize any formula. Just swap x and y, and after you swap x and y, you have to change the sign of the coordinate which is on the left hand side. Why left hand side? Again, to quick recap, because in anti-clockwise rotation, we are moving from right to left. Okay, now after this much is clear to you, let's simply take one example and solve that. Suppose the coordinates given to you are 5, 7. And the rule we have to apply 90 degree anti-clockwise. They will flip, it will become 7 and 5. And as the rule says that y has to be negative, so 7 will become negative. If the original coordinate given are negative 8 and 9, they will flip. 9 will come here, negative 8 here, and 9 positive will turn negative, because again the left hand side coordinate has to change its sign. So simply you can apply this rule and work out for any given point how the point should look after 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation about origin. Now this much is all about the points that are rotated applying the rule. But usually you get an exam question in which a complete figure is given to you, maybe a triangle, parallelogram, square or any other figure. And then what you have to do is you have to apply the formula for 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation and rotate that figure. So how do we do that in that particular case? How we apply the formula and plot it on a coordinate grid is what now we will see on a graph. Here is an example question. To learn rotation 90 degree anti-clockwise about origin. So the question says triangle PQR, we have to rotate it 90 degree anti-clockwise about origin. The formula that is used for rotating any point 90 degree anti-clockwise is the coordinates of the point x and y have to be flipped first, that is y and x. And then the y coordinate will turn its sign opposite. Means if it is positive, it will become negative. If the point is negative, it will become positive. I will write down the coordinates of the original triangle PQR. So point P, its coordinates are -6, -3. Point Q's coordinates are -4, -1, and point R's coordinates are -3, -4. These are my original coordinates. After 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation, the new coordinates that will be obtained applying formula, -3 will change its position and come towards the left hand side, and it also has to change its sign. So it is already negative. Changing sign means it has to become positive. So it will become +3 and -6. Q coordinates will flip and it will become -4. And -4 will take place of
the left hand side coordinate and will change its sign, become plus 4, and negative 3 will take the other place, that is on the right hand side. After application of 90 degree anti-clockwise formula and obtaining the three new coordinates P dash, Q dash and R dash, the next step is to plot them on the graph grid. So here I have already plotted three points. P dash is positive 3, negative 6. Q dash over here is positive 1, negative 4. And R dash over here is positive 4, negative 3. After your newly obtained three points are plotted, you have to join them using a ruler and a pencil. And your new figure, triangle P dash, Q dash, R dash, is ready after 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation. You can observe it here in the picture. That original triangle was in quadrant 3. When you move anti-clockwise, means you are moving in the opposite direction of the clock, that's why you moved from quadrant 3 to quadrant 2. So whenever you are rotating any figure 90 degree anti-clockwise about origin, the object that is in third quadrant will move to second quadrant. Object originally in second quadrant will move to first quadrant. Object originally in first quadrant will move to fourth quadrant, and so on. So this is how our construction of 90 degree anti-clockwise about origin should look. Now there is another way to identify whether your construction or whether the plotting that you did on the graph paper is right or not. What you can do in that case is select any point from triangle 1, that is the originally given triangle. I am selecting point Q over here, and then select the point after its rotation. So after its rotation, it becomes Q dash. So I selected that as well. And the rotation is happening about origin. That is why the origin has to be marked. Now join Q to Q origin with a ruler. And then from origin, join to the Q dash as well. You will notice that when you join point Q and Q dash through origin, that means Q to origin, origin to Q dash, it forms a 90 degree angle. This also indicates that your construction or your plotting of the graph of triangle PQR after its rotation 90 degree anti-clockwise is correct. You can also check that with all three points. But if not all three, even if you check this with any one of the points, that whether your plotting is right or not, it will help you to understand that. So this is how we complete the construction of 90 degree anti-clockwise rotation about origin.